Howdy, y'all. I'm sorry I can't be with you here this parent meeting because we're going to be in Palo Canyon for our anniversary. But I just wanted to go over some more app stuff that's on the up and coming and just some reminders. I have three things I really want to go over. The first is just going back to Instagram. A lot of our students have what they call Finstas or fake Instagrams or spam accounts or whatever you want to call that. These are accounts where they post more photos more frequently that aren't so serious, or they don't want to put on their real Instagram because it's not worthy of, you know, being on the main channel or whatever. But a lot of them will disguise this with like different usernames. They won't put their names on there. They won't put a profile picture that looks like them, but they're posting things that are not really of their character. Some things can be inappropriate, sometimes they're not, but I'm seeing a lot of just profanity used, and I know that it's a really good way, because it's private, for them to post pictures that aren't necessarily appropriate. They don't want their youth pastors or teachers or parents seeing, because they know it's not really the best idea to be posting those things. So you might just talk to your kid about it. If you don't want to, that's okay. Just know that there is a possibility that that might be out there somewhere. The second app I want to talk about is something that we just discovered. It's called LABC. And this is an app that really promotes the fact that you can do things anonymously. So it's a messaging app where you can find whoever you want to chat with. And it's like Snapchat in the way that you can send things and they can disappear. So really this app is just totally promoting abuse. A lot of kids are putting this in their Instagram bio, so anybody who knows their Instagram can click on it and message them anonymously and give them feedback. That's what the app is really promoting. But, so two things. You have to be 18 to use this app. It asks you if you're 18. So if they're going through, then they're lying about their age. They do this, LABC does this, because they've had tons of issues with underage people just abusing each other and bullying each other, and they don't want any part of that. They also do not allow bullying on their app. That's another one of just the things they have you sign. However, all of this is just to back their side up, because they know that their app is promoting abuse, and that there's a huge chance that it's being used to really bully and be able to take away the messages that you sent and you know that aren't appropriate. So look out for that. It's really just not a great idea. And I know a lot of these things are super scary, but I found this app. It's called Bark. And it is an app that really, it's just a monitoring app. But I love it because it has the most coverage of any monitoring tool that I've found so far. So it monitors all types of apps through Snapchat, LABC, those things that can go through and then disappear. It'll detect those if something else is going on. So it has social media monitoring, it has text monitoring, email monitoring, 24/7, like all around monitoring. So it monitors things that are being sent. If it's, you know, like sensing a lot of profanity, it'll let you know. If it's sensing some phrases that are very close to self-harm or bullying or sexting or adult content, it'll let you know. And it doesn't just monitor the things that are being said, but also, I guess the activity is a good way to put that. So sites or things or pictures that they're following or looking at, if they sense that it's not appropriate for your student, then it'll detect it and let you know. Here's the thing that I love about it though, is it monitors and detects it, but it doesn't let you snoop. So you can set your filters to let you know when it detects something that's not appropriate, but it's not letting you snoop. So it is detecting the things that aren't appropriate, and it's alerting you, but it's giving your kids some sense of privacy still. So if there's nothing going on, then it's not going to alert you. It gives them a sense of security and individuality without you being all up in your business, in their business. So those are just the three things that I really wanted to go over. Bark does a free week or month trial, so you guys can always test it out and see if it's for you, and if it's not, then all right. But that's all I have for you guys today, so have a wonderful rest of your meeting.
Really, really proud of Kait, just how she continues to grow in this position, and she's doing an awesome job with girls. Really, really cool. Okay, we got a special guest tonight, I promised you. I'm really excited to have Detective Alan Branch with us, and he's going to talk to us about, I'm calling it cell phone safety. I'm going to let him call it whatever he wants to. I'll let him tell you what he does, too. Brilliant, brilliant guy, though, and so I'm excited to be able to hear from him. Alan, come on up, man.
What does that entail? Basically, I'm the child pornography and online solicitation guy. There are two of us in the department. So I don't deal with teddy bears and rainbows. So this week I closed a few cases, and I'm like, yeah, I closed a few cases. And I went down to the bottom to see how many cases I have left. I'm still at 67. So does that kind of give you an idea of how many cases we have? And there's just two of us that work those kind of cases. Okay, so how many of y'all are bringing kids in for the first time? This is your first meeting? Okay, I'm sorry. Hopefully these meetings won't be like this all the time. Sorry. but the important thing is I'm here to talk about, like you said, cell phone safety. Doing what I do, I would say that cell phones have become an epidemic for our high schools and junior highs, and even elementary school. So if y'all have elementary students as well, you need to be aware of what's going on. So before we get started, I kind of want to make this biblical in a way. Can y'all turn, y'all have Bible? No? Yes? If you do, turn to 2 Samuel chapter 11. We'll read the first 5 verses. In the spring, at the time when kings go off to war, David sent Joab out with the king's men and the whole Israelite army. They destroyed the Ammonites and besieged Rabbah, but David remained in Jerusalem. One evening, David got up from his bed and walked around on the roof of the palace. From the roof, he saw a woman bathing. The woman was very beautiful, and David sent someone to find out about her. The man said, "Isn't this Bathsheba, the daughter of Eliam, the wife of Uriah the Hittite?" Then David sent messengers to get her. She came to him, and he slept with her. And she had purified herself from her uncleanness. Then she went back home. The woman conceived and sent word to David, saying, "I am pregnant." I mention that passage because we're talking about David, who is the man after God's own heart, right? He also had men that were telling him right then and there, "Isn't this the wife of Uriah, your head hero?" David even had Nathan, right, to be a man of counsel for him. And yet, David still fell into temptation. He still fell into a very grievous sin that had some pretty dire consequences. So the reason I mention this is because we all can fall into this temptation in one way or another. And just like David was able to see Bathsheba from his rooftop, our cell phone is our rooftop. Any one of us, adult, child, or whatever, can fall into that kind of temptation. choice on not seeing the picture. See what I'm saying? The picture shows up and you have to accept it or decline it. So the bark is not going to be foolproof when some one of the other kids airdrops everybody they can in the school. And that we're seeing a lot of that. So what that means is whether you are doing everything you can do for your children, they can still be exposed to pornography. And then that just sparks curiosity, and then we're going down a David trail. Okay, the other thing I think about BARC is it'd be great for y'all to monitor, but everybody in here has an iPhone, knows about FaceTime. Okay, FaceTime is a great tool, but what it is, it's you talking to another person, you can see their face, for those Android users. I'm sure y'all have something similar to that on Android. But so FaceTime and Skype are two dangerous ones because we can have a conversation and that conversation can get sexual and mom and dad will never know about it. And the only reason that I know about it is because I work these kind of cases, and I've got a Skype case right now that I'm working. And we see every cell phone that we get, we have to look at everything that's on those cell phones because we're having to investigate the case. And most of those cases are an Instagram case where two people have been sending inappropriate pictures to each other. So what am I finding on every cell phone that I've analyzed? I'm finding porn. I'm finding FaceTime. You know what a thumbnail is? A thumbnail is basically like an image capture of a video. So it can be an image capture of a picture as well. But we'll see thumbnails of a conversation. And what it'll look like, if you've ever done FaceTime, you know that you have the big screen and then you have the little screen. So the big screen is the person you're talking to, the little screen is you. So you can see you talking to the person. So I will see screenshots or thumbnails of those images. And when these kids are talking to their girlfriend or boyfriend and they're doing inappropriate things, they're snapshotting those images. And so those images are caught on their phone. So those are things that the parents will not know about because it's not going to show up on their phone if they don't snapshot it. Or it's not something that you can see just by going through their phone and seeing what's on there. It's things that we see because we get into the background of the phone. Scary? Okay. Now, the reason that I'm here to talk to y'all tonight is not to scare you. It is scary because it's an epidemic. It's what we have to deal with now as parents. It's not going to go away. However, the more knowledge that we have, the more tools that we have, the better we can be at trying to counteract what's going on with our kids. So, everybody heard of Snapchat? Okay. Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter. Anybody ever heard of Musical.ly, LiveMe, TikTok? Those are the main apps that we see that are very detrimental to the kids. Snapchat, all the kids think that those images disappear or that the videos disappear. They don't. Snapchat keeps everything. Just to give you an example, I have 6 arrest warrants on my sergeant's desk right now for one case involving Snapchat at a local school here in Arlington. I won't tell you the name of the school, but that's my reality. That's what I deal with. So that's just Snapchat. Instagram is one of our major ones that we have to deal with because y'all heard about the Finstas. That's real. Now, if we have an investigation, we can find out who that Finsta belongs to because they have to put in an email address, or we can go through the IP address and find out whose account that is. And then sometimes we have to call the parents and say, hey, you know what your child is doing. Musical.ly called sale, distribution, or display of harmful material. And within the high school or the junior highs, if we have one kid that posts something on Instagram of another kid that's inappropriate, or post it or sends it to another kid, then we've got an offense. That's a Class A misdemeanor. Most of the time, we are not going to charge the kid with that charge. Basically, if we did, we wouldn't have anything else to do with our job. We'd be doing that all day, every day. So the way that we prevent extra work for us is we put it back on the parent. If we get those kind of cases, we notify the parents and say, hey, this is what we found. Be a parent. Discipline your kid accordingly. And we'll contact both parents. Because, think about this. Your child has an inappropriate image of another child on their phone. What happens when they turn 18? They have an image of a 14-year-old on their phone. They now have child pornography. Okay? So, a lot of people don't think of that. That when they grow older and now they have, a nice job, they're in college, they go off to the military, and they still have those photos on their phone of when they were kids. Kids and kids, it's different for them. We're not going to charge the kid at that time, but when they become older, if they still have those images, they now have child pornography. And that's something new that we're coming across, is people with old images. That the definition of child pornography is, it's based on the age of the child at the time the photo was taken, not on the age of the person at the time that it's caught. Does that make sense? The age of the child at the time the photo was taken. So if we got kids in junior high doing that, and then those kids turn into adults, if they have not gotten a new phone, or sometimes those images transfer to the new phone, and they still have those images on their phone, it's a mess that we don't want to have to deal with. So another thing as parents to be concerned about. That's a different offense. Solicitation of the mind. That's when we get into TikTok, Live Me, Musical.ly, and even nowadays Twitter is a bad one. Twitter has a program called Periscope. Have y'all heard of Periscope? Basically, it's a live broadcasting option that kids can get on Twitter and do a live broadcast. Kind of like Musical.ly or something, but it's live. And they can be talking to a group of people, that group of people can tell them things, not just talk to them, hey, I like your video or whatever, but they've got people there telling them, take your clothes off. posting inappropriate videos and pictures of other kids so that they can get people to click and follow them. The more followers they have, the more popular they are in school. So, communication is key. Also, I mean, number one, you pray for your kids, which I don't think we even have to mention in here, but pray for your kids. Communicate with them. They need to be aware of this on a very constant basis. And then, you know, if you do choose to have a smartphone for your kids, have every kind of app possible that you can get on there to help monitor. Have those conversations with your kids. Sexual performance by a child is the other office that we deal with a lot. What is sexual performance by a child? Sexual performance